In a previous video, we reviewed the Milwaukee cable stapler, and we left that video with a question: how will these cable clips perform in a fire situation? Will they help to prevent premature collapse of cables? So we've come down to the eFIXX cable test fire performance center to find out.
Our three cable supports of choice are a top metallic twin and earth clip, a center traditional plastic one, and the Milwaukee cable staple at the very bottom. We've fired up our blowtorch, and you notice it is pointing directly at that staple.
It is, and I notice you've got the nail underneath the cable clip.
Yeah, on the middle plastic one, because in a previous video, it was suggested that the nail itself would support the cable in the event of a fire, and I think I've just proved it won't.
I think you're right there, yeah, and that fire is now well ahold. So these are 6mm² twin and earth cables, or twin and CPC as Gary would call it, being factually correct. And that's a raging inferno. Now, what's the importance here, Gary, of what we're seeing here? Why do we use metallic clips?
Yeah, surface wiring systems need to be supported for the longest possible amount of time in the event of a fire to prevent entanglement. And that's normally entanglement maybe of people coming in as part of the rescuing. So if the fire was raging at a really bad state, they probably wouldn't enter the building because it would be structurally unsound. But our firefighters will be coming into a building. That surface wiring system needs to be held in place so it doesn't fall down and obviously cause entanglement for them. And we can see how that PVC clip, even though it had the nail at the bottom, collapsed very quickly. The other two are supporting the cables perfectly.
Yeah, and this would be a large, you know, could be a large group of cables. Yeah, they start hanging down from the ceilings. Yeah, and you can imagine you're in breathing apparatus in a smoke-filled room, trying to find your way through, and this has actually killed firefighters. So it is important. People said, oh no, you'd be out of the building by the time this happens. Well, if they're coming in to rescue you, the last thing you want is them getting entangled.
And you can see at this stage, can't you? It's absolutely raging away. The PVC is obviously melting away, but the top clip and the bottom one have held firm and the cables are still being supported. Remember, you've got to look at the room and seeing what the fire's like, depending on whether anyone's going to be in there. We've moved on now to the point where the fire is just calming itself down. So we can now investigate how well those clips are in place, because you notice we didn't have any movement or rocking around, did we?
No, not in the building, but now just scrape away the charred remnants of the cables that are held in place. You can see we're through to the copper there, so most of the PVC is gone. I thought it was a really thin clip. I thought that would come straight out. It didn't. The nail did from the PVC clip. And from the metallic clip, that is a fire-supporting clip, that's out. But the cable's actually held remarkably well.
I'm going to pull them against it with the cable in order to work its way out. It still hasn't come out, and finally it did. That held well.
Well, I'd say that's pretty conclusive, that the Milwaukee clips perform equally, if not better, than this fire-rated clip that people may be used to using. However, don't rely on this video in a court of law, because the eFIXX Fire Performance Test Center isn't validated to give certificates. But if you haven't seen the review of this tool that puts the clips in, check out, it's over here.